Welcome back to Living 808. Now, everyone learns differently, and that's why Kapolei High School created an alternative learning program there 5 years ago. Now, the program called Ho'ola Leadership Academy is thriving. It's become quite popular among students who have difficulty learning in a traditional classroom setting. Joan Lewis, a teacher at Ho'ola Leadership Academy, joins me now with more on the program. Hello. Thanks for being here.
Oh, thank you for having me.
So tell us about this program that was created at Kapolei 5 years ago.
We started the program because we realized that if we want to make sure all of our students are successful in high school, we have to be open to the possibility that they will need different things from us. As different as our students are, that's as different as we need to be in giving them what they need to be successful.
Okay, so how did you guys think to create this program?
At the time, our school was very concerned about graduation rates and very concerned about retention, students being held back. And we looked very closely at what it was that they needed. And basically, we designed a program that gives them all 4 years to kind of find their way and find their space. We make sure that we provide an environment that is both academically challenging, but also very safe and family-like.
Okay, so what kind of courses? Can you give me an example?
Well, they take the full range of the academic courses. So a student that graduates from Ho'ola will meet all the college requirements necessary for four-year universities. On top of that, they also finish out of our natural resources pathway and Hawaiian language. They'll have 2 years of Hawaiian language. So it's very site-based, very culture-based, very local-based.
Well, I love that because, you know, I did okay in a traditional classroom setting, but it's kind of boring sometimes, right?
You know, and that's the funny thing. And it turns out we're all excellent at certain things, maybe not so excellent at others. So if we only continue doing the things that certain kids are excellent at, we think that they're the only excellent kids. In Ho'ola, we mix it up. So students that have performed in the more traditional academic sense, they find themselves very much challenged in doing hands-on, in being creative, in performing, and being kinesthetic learners. So we push everybody to be better in all the areas, even as we help them hone their own special gifts.
Well, I feel like that is kind of the way that schools are going to, by learning by doing, right? Getting
right.
involved, and that's how they're learning. So it sounds like you guys started that, you know, already on your own.
We are very excited because a lot of what we've been doing, that you're right, that's what the experts are saying now needs to happen. So you'll hear terms like blended learning, where they do a little time in class, some independent time, some hands-on time. Our whole program's been designed that way, so our students get the full workaround.
Okay, now one of the students, or one of your former students, was supposed to be with us this morning, but I know he's stuck in traffic. I believe we have some video too. Well, tell us about Solomon.
Solomon was actually one of the first four-year students we've had. And so in a public school, to say that you've only had one set of teachers for 4 years and that this child was ours for 4 years is kind of a big deal. Mm-hmm. Solomon was one of them, and he showed every sign of needing the kind of environment Ho'ola could provide. Solomon always wanted to do his own thing. And it was sometimes a struggle for us to help.
Sure.
All right, Solomon, back with the rest of us.
I have a child like that.
Right, right.
It's hard being a parent of somebody
like that. It's like, okay, love the creativity, but a little more here with us. And so for 4 years, that's what Solomon did. He did a little of what we needed him to do, a little of what he wanted to do, and just took the time. And if there was a student that needed all 4 years of a safe environment, Solomon was that student. But now he is an entrepreneur, he is a successful salon owner, and probably one of the most amazing hair designers. And I cannot imagine that's a thing now, the
hair
fade designing, being able to, you know, do things with the clippers.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a thing.
He's the man. I looked online at his work, and I saw him start the, you know, he's like shaving somebody's head, and I saw that, okay, you know, this is cool. But then when you see the finished product, I mean, it's really art.
I know. And it's so funny because that's what he did. And so, you know, we all had that classmate that was always drawing, and always the teacher was like, put your stuff away. And Solomon was able to, and I'd like to think we were wise enough to be able to say, Solomon, put it away for now. Let's come back to it. Can we do a little, I mean, to help him manage that so that we never were the people that were dream killers. Because really, teachers should not be dream killers.
So, I mean, this sounds like a great program. Is it, are other schools adopting this program or?
Well, Kapolei High School started doing something similar a few years ago. But what we're finding is Kohala High School, which is a kind of like a sister school for us, they're doing their own version. And I think what will happen is every school has to know their own students and what will work for their own students. Kohala is showing excellent outcomes. They're only in their first year, but everybody that's involved is very excited about what they think is going on there and what they're seeing. Same kind of results that we're seeing.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's a wonderful thing you guys are doing, and it's true. I mean, you're helping the students, you know, because like we said, everyone learns differently.
And I think maybe not, they're helping us too because, man, it is always an exciting day in Ho'ola. Some days too exciting, but, you know, always exciting.
Yes, I know what you mean. Well, thank you so much. If people want more information.
They can just, how do they find us?
We'll get that
Kapolei High School. Yep.
We'll put it on our website.
Okay, got it.
Thank you so much, Joan. Thank you.